Good morning, guys. What is up? Today is Saturday, June 23rd, and it's a gloomy day today, but it's a good day because I'm 2 weeks out, 2 weeks out from Van Pro Show. So today I am heading to Mississauga to see my coach. Once a month we meet up to do body fat percentage, body composition, just to make sure we're like heading in the right direction, that I'm not losing lean muscle, that we're actually losing fat, and that we're progressing the way we want to. So we do that and then we train together. So I'm going to do cardio now, then head down to Toronto to meet my coach. And I thought I'll take you guys along with me. I've done a few videos where I recorded our meetups and our sessions before, and you guys have found them really interesting. So I want to keep you guys in the loop and take you with me. So right now I'm going to have meal one, do my cardio, and then I will head down and I'll show you guys what I'm having in meal one. So guys, I just got this in the mail. This is the new Hard Magnum Opus. So Opus is a non-stimulant pre-workout. It's going to give you that energy and the focus and the good pump, but it's not going to give you the crash that caffeine would, or it's not going to give you the hype or the racing heart rate that a stimulant would. The good thing about this Opus, the brand new one, is this flavor. Can you guys see that? It is the red berry candy. So it tastes like those little gummies, and it is so freaking good, guys. Like, you need to try this. It's so good. Okay, so I have meal one here. I have 3 butter popcorn rice cakes with my coconut oil. I put sea salt on them, and then I put them in the freezer so the coconut oil hardens on the rice cakes, and they're so good that way. I have 1 butter popcorn rice cake with this double fruit jam. There's the rice cakes. And then I have my fish. And that's meal one. And obviously I'm gonna have some of the zucchini because it's bae. 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 Hey guys, so I just got to Royal Windsor Fitness. This is where my team trains out of, and this is where our coaches are. So I'm here now, I'm gonna meet with Sean, and I'll take you guys along with me, and we'll see what today has in store.
Yeah, that then step up. 15. So you gotta do, let's do 15 reps. 1, 2, 3. Good. Nice. That's good. Step up.
Thank you. I wanna go to court, fuck. Got a budget for a lawyer, fuck. I'm on the run for the month, I'm in the butt. Paid 200 for my little nigga stuck in the air, got me paranoid. I'm getting money, that's a nigga, nigga category. Double M, I got cheese out of California.
You can find me in the streets, even in the crowd.
Hella ratchet because I trained already and it's raining and my hair is frizzy, sweaty, and it's fine. I just wanted to come on here real quick to kind of talk about what happened yesterday with my coach. As you can see, obviously we didn't do the body comp, and I know it's a letdown, I'm sorry, but I had no control over the situation, so I just wanted to explain why and what's happening moving forward. So yesterday, Sean didn't want to do the body comp because he saw how it affected me last time, and I'm in a good mindset right now that we don't want to kind of mess with my mindset being 2 weeks out from my next show. So if the results weren't what I expected and I got upset over it, then it might like change my mindset and then I'll be in a bad place maybe before the show. So he kind of just thought it would be best to not do the body comp. Also because it doesn't really matter at this point. Why doesn't it matter? Because when you're dieting, you're losing weight and you're not necessarily building muscle. So it's obvious that you will lose some muscle and some fat. And seeing how it affected me last time, he didn't want to do it this time. And also to say that when you do step on stage, nobody knows your weight, nobody knows your body fat percentage. It doesn't matter. It's not like you have to meet a certain weight class for bikini, or it's not like it's a competition for who's the lowest body fat. It doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. What matters is that you come on stage looking your best and bringing your best, and whether that be at 20% body fat or at 6% body fat, it's different for everybody. So that's why it doesn't really matter. So obviously I really wanted him to do it more for the purpose of you guys, because I like showing that stuff with you guys and I felt good about it. I wanted to know like where we were, because I feel like I've improved since the last time we did it. So I was kind of disappointed that we didn't do it, but it is what it is, and he wasn't having it, so I wasn't gonna push him. Okay, so I'll kind of like backtrack what I've been doing since the last show. So between my last show and my next show, it's a total of 4 weeks. So right now I'm at the 2 week mark, so I'm right in the middle. After the last show, there was about a week, like the week after the show, my body's always the same. It always has to, it takes about a week for all the water to flush out, for everything to regulate, for the body to regulate back to its normal state. That being because I was on drip dry, which is a natural diuretic. And obviously you're going to be more drier when you're on that, and it's going to affect how you look, and just with the carb manipulation and the big cheat meal, that all affects your body's water. And yeah, so the week after show, it always takes me about a week to fluctuate and get back to where my normal is. And then after about that first week, I was back down to my normal pre-peak week weight, and I felt good. So I kind of just grinded it out last week. My macros are about what they were 4 weeks out, and they didn't really change much after that. I upped my macros after the show right to where we were at 4 weeks out, which wasn't a drastic change from peak week macros at all. It's just during peak week, we did more manipulation with like depletion and then loading. So peak week macros were all over the place, and then after the show I went back to like a steady, consistent amount of macros. And then yesterday Sean sent me my new plan. So for the next 2 weeks moving forward, well basically for the next week moving forward, we're changing up the macros. So what we've done is we've increased carbs and decreased fats. Sean feels like people respond better to lower fat and higher carb. And I also do feel that way with my body as well, but I just like love fat. So it's really hard for me to go low fat because I just love fat so much. Like my mouth craves fats. Like it's so weird. Like I'd rather have fats over carbs most of the time. So moving forward, we are dropping the fats, upping the carbs. I'm gonna be having 5 high days, so 5 days where I'm high carb, low fat, and then I'm gonna have 2 days where I'm low carb, higher fat. So it's so we're kind of like carb cycling, which is something we haven't done before. So on those low days, it's gonna be on my rest days or my cardio only days. So it won't really affect my training or anything like that. And honestly, the low days aren't even that low. Like I'm very happy and like satisfied with what the macros are for low days. So like I'm not too concerned at all. And so I'm just doing that for this coming week, and then starting next Sunday will be like peak week. So then that's when we will do like the depletion macros again, and then the loading. So that week's gonna be different on its own, and I'll keep you guys posted with what we plan on doing for peak week. Sean's gonna be sending my peak week plan towards the end of the week, and so I'll do a vlog about what we plan on doing for my next peak week when I get my new plan. So with this new carb cycling, I think what was the hardest thing for me to like wrap my head around was the fact that I'm gonna be eating more. And it's just because like I'm stuck in that mindset where less will get me to where I want to be, like harder dieting, more cardio, starve yourself. Like it's just that basic bodybuilding mindset, and I feel like a lot of people think that way. A lot of people think like you need to eat less to lose weight, or you need to do more cardio to lose weight. But as we saw from my last check-in, that's not the case. So one part of me is like wanting to diet harder and eat less and do more, but then the other side of me knows that if I want to bring my best to Vancouver, I need to be fuller. My muscles need to be fuller, and in order to do that, I need to load longer, or my body just needs to be replenished for a longer period of time versus just the 2 loading days before the show. My body needs just more food overall to look fuller every day versus just trying to load 2 days before the show. So like I was saying, one side of me wants to diet harder, push harder, do more, but then the other side of me, like my subconscious self knows, and my coaching self, like me telling a client self knows that if I want to look better, I need to be fuller and harder, and in order to do that, I need to eat more so my muscles become fuller. But it's, like I said, it's just that natural mindset that we have as a competitor or as a girl, as a female, that if we eat more, we're going to get fat. And that's not the case. And I always preach it to my clients, but then when my coach tries to preach it to me, it's like a different story, right? So I was trying to put myself in my client's position and what I would be telling my client. Like, you're not going to get fat from eating a little bit more carbs. Like, if anything, it's going to do your body better. Your muscles are going to be fuller. You're going to have more energy to kill those workouts, and you're just going to be better in the end. And that's the overall goal. I need to be fuller next time I'm on stage so my muscles look harder, because the fuller your muscles are, the more they press against your skin, and then you just look tighter. My coach put it in a good way. So think about like after your workout, you feel you look so good, right? Because you have that pump. And you have that pump because your muscles are so full and they're pressing against the skin. And that's when I feel I look my best, like after my workout, because my muscles are full, they're pressing against the skin, and there's no water anywhere because your muscles are pressing against the skin. So that's why I need to be fuller so I look harder. So with that being said, I got some feedback from one of the head judges, and she said, both judges said, like, this was my best package to date. They really liked my front post. If there was one thing I could change, they could change, it's to bring in my glute ham region just a little bit tighter. And that's what I've been grinding my ass to do the last 2 weeks. And I feel like I've made good improvements since the last show. And I was comparing, like, I know it's not good to compare pictures, but like I was comparing to myself. So I was comparing myself 2 weeks out from the show that I just did compared to 2 weeks out from my next show, which is like today's body. And I'm already ahead of where I was. So I've already beat my best self in the matter of like 4 weeks. So that's awesome. So I'm really happy with that. I feel like my glute ham tie-in is harder. I really like my new front pose. I just need to keep continuing to practice my posing and being confident on stage. And at this show, they're also going to be doing my makeup, which is something that I normally do myself. So it'll be interesting to see. I'm kind of nervous because I feel like how your hair and makeup is affects like how you shine on stage, because it's how you feel about yourself, right? And like, I feel good and confident when I do my own hair and makeup, but letting it be in someone else's hands is kind of nerve-wracking, because I never really like when somebody else does my hair and makeup. Like, I like it, but I'm not like in love with it. But when I do it myself, like, I love it. So we will see how that goes. I'm gonna do my own hair just because I don't wanna change up my look too much. Like, I don't want curls. I don't like how I look on stage with curls. I really like my overall look on stage, so I wanna keep it kind of the same. But it'll be good to have a professional do my makeup. So maybe I blend better, and so I'm excited for that. We will see, and I fly out in like a week and a half, which is insane. And I think I'm like 12 days out now. So I'm really excited moving forward, and thanks guys for following and watching. I'll keep you guys posted with what we are doing for peak week, and I hope you enjoyed like the little footage of the circuit Sean brought me through. It literally kicked my ass. I'm not good at that type of training. Like, my style of training is pick things up and put them down, easy, bodybuilding, I got that. But like, when it comes to conditioning or circuits or anything that involves like endurance or like plyometrics, I suck. Like, it literally takes my heart and soul with it. So it was good to like push myself to that level. I was literally dripping. I was dripping, it was so gross. It was so good actually. So the swass was real. Anyways, thanks guys for watching. I'm glad you're tuning in and following my journey. And I'll see you in the next vlog.